are the new guild owner, I hear. Welcome to Deadwoods. Turns out he didn't have the stomach for this kind of thing, but left a few buildings we can make use of. Take a look around. Anyway, I'm Slynn, your guild assistant. Let me give you a heads up. Gladiator championships are organized at the start of each month. Then there's the old arena named the Ring of Death. We can join the action there each week. They organize a variety of different fight types. And lastly, the Deadwoods has its fair share of problems. Bandits, beasts, feral undead. So expect to be contacted and asked for deadly gladiator services outside of the arena. Alright, lad. You can get your gladiators and their items here. Expand your guild or purchase buildings to be able to hire new types of gladiators. This is the weekly Ring of Death arena that I was talking about. New quests will appear up here. And finally, your timeline. Press the play button to set it moving. If some of your gladiators die, don't worry. Temple of Revival sits within the guild, resurrecting gladiators. But it takes some time. However, should you want to bring them back to life instantly, it will cost you mana crystals. Yes, even in the middle of championships, comes in handy.
A group of unsatisfied peasant vandals have burnt down a windmill. I need you to bring them to justice. I didn't bring gladiator games to Deadwoods just to let peasants enjoy savage entertainment. I knew gladiators would come in handy for these sort of tasks. A few drunk bandits have beat up two guards and claimed ownership of the graveyard arena. I need you to take them down before they do any more harm.
We need your help, my lord. The Church of the Dead has risen our ancestors from their graves and turned them into ghouls, and they intend to raise more soon. Well, they stuck to old cemeteries and burial sites before, but they ran out of bodies and now raid our graveyard. Many thanks, my lord. The dead can rest in peace. necromancers turned a man's grandfather into a deformed ghoul and sold him to the traveling fair. Now he's doing street performance tricks. What kinds? I don't know, jumping through fire circles, dancing, looking cute and smiling. It's a ghoul, so it's funny to people if they see it smiling and... at the northern border of the village, where the farm begins. Many thanks. Unfortunately, a couple of villagers caught you laughing at the fairground's dancing ghoul, so we lost some of their respect. However, you won some gold for managing to hold on to the pull-up bar for 2 minutes. Good job! Under normal circumstances, it does. It's a common scam. Makes you lose your grip. No, I got a spellcaster to keep it from rotating. He owed me a favor. Sure. Although I also got him to cast a mild levitation spell on you. Now they've really crossed the line. They arrived in the middle of the funeral, told us how they're in a hurry to close a killer deal with some traveling flesh trader. And they're one ghoul short. The people want revenge. No, they were thrilled about not having to dig this time. It's hard work, they say. It was a lot to ask, but the people will always be grateful to you for being on our side.
A pack of feral ghouls roam the forest near the village. I'd like you to dispose of them before further blame is foisted upon me.
Feral and dead are those who have risen on their own and behave like wild beasts. They began to appear around a decade ago, along with the Crimson Mists. Normally, necromancers raise the undead and bind them to mana crystals. Whoever holds the crystal, you know, can control that undead. They sell most of them to the Andarian army to help keep the borders safe. That's why the church is allowed to raise the dead without any restrictions. You're really new here, huh? Our district, Deadwoods, borders the Kingdom of Tyrell, and relations between our Kingdom of Andarion and Tyrell are not to be admired. Well, but the thing is, they don't shy away from selling their undead to anybody who offers a better price. It all started about 10 years ago, growing more and more common. Various rumors circulate as to their cause. Some say that the High Necromancer is to blame, as his dark arts disturb the balance of nature. Others claim it's due to the influence of the Baroness. Well, it ain't customary in these parts for an elven woman to rule, much less a lowborn one. Suffice to say, the common folk don't see eye to eye with her. Sure, like I said, she's a lowborn elf who charmed the Baron's son. When the elder Baron died, his son married her despite her social status. Well, long story short, the young Baron died too, from a blighted forest troll of all things. Thus, the rulership of the Deadwoods fell to her.
Excellent work! There's nothing worse than cleaning up after another's mess. The Church of the Dead, of course. But that schemer, the High Necromancer, sows rumors in the minds of the gullible townsfolk, pinning the blame on me. He bloviates about how a red-haired, low-born she-elf witch will bring doom upon us, feeding into the superstitions that already surround me. I need you to spread some truth, round up your gladiators, and get them talking about how the Church of the Dead's dark arts are responsible for the feral undead rising. Get those blighted peasants off my back. Many do. Red-haired she-elf ruling the Deadwoods. It's a curse that brought us the Crimson Mists, they say. The High Necromancer is working hard to spread this narrative. The Church of the Dead has meddled with dark arts for years. The Creator himself doesn't know what goes on in those lightless chambers of theirs.
Well, it's undeniable that feral undead rise on their own after every crimson mist. But swive me if I know what's causing the mist. They started 10 years ago, and the Church of the Dead has been here long before that.
My necromancers discovered a farm that was once an old war burial ground. Unfortunately, the peasants refused to let us dig up their precious crops. I need you to pay them a visit. Turns out my necromancers are not as competent as I'd like to believe. Fools! Turns out it was only a pet cemetery. Puppies and kittens? No, we do not. Who will purchase undead pets? All of them? Fine. I'll contact you once they are unearthed and jumping around again.